Dave couldn't be here because of the rough water that we've just experienced. He is still in Ashland and they're waiting for the waves to calm down so they can stay out here. But Amy will tell you their story and let's give her a very warm welcome.
Well, I just wanted to start by saying a big thank you to the library for having us here and to the folk group for bringing us in as well. So my name is Amy Freeman and over here I have Olivia Ridge and she is our support staff. She's driving along, shadowing the route, and she made it possible for myself and the community to be here today because of that rough weather we had. So we drove here and the sailboat will come, I think, early Saturday morning. So keep an eye out for it coming down the canal at some point. But I'll start by telling you a little story about the previous adventure that Dave and I took. And I also kind of want to share with you a bit about how I fell in love with wild places and sort of why they're super important to me. And then we'll launch into the purpose of this canoe, all the signatures on it. So to begin with, this is the area that I will be talking about a bit later today, and the area that I fell in love with in northeastern Minnesota. So you can see I'm reading the Superior National Forest, and then this is the Canadian border here. This is Lake Superior over here, so Grand Marais, Minnesota is right there. This is a spot where I grew up in the city. I grew up in St. Paul, Minnesota, and my parents would take me up here a lot as a kid to experience Lake Superior and the woods surrounding. And eventually it led to canoe trips in the Boundary Waters canoe area